Mutant League Football is one of the best sports games for the Sega Genesis and one of the most unique football titles of all time. Made in 1993 by Electronic Arts, we haven't seen a sequel despite the demand for an updated look. We got close when there was a Mutant League Football Easter egg in Madden 09 for the Xbox 360, but EA has given no indication that they would make an updated game. But that all changed with the introduction of Mutant Football League, a game made by Digital Dreams, and it's currently $20 available on PC, Xbox One, and PlayStation 4. So does Mutant Football League fulfill the nostalgia of Mutant League Football? Let's take a look. Mutant Football League offers everything that the original version did, but updates it for a modern-day feel. The original had 16 teams with 5 fields, and Mutant Football League has 18 teams with 18 fields. However, there are teams that are locked, and luckily you don't have to pay for them, but you do have to unlock them the old-fashioned way, by playing the game. The thresholds for the unlocks aren't that extreme and will keep you playing. While there isn't too much of a difference content-wise between Mutant League Football and Mutant Football League, there are some mechanical improvements. One of the biggest differences is that instead of the top-down view of the original, the camera is situated just above the quarterback's head, and this allows you to see downfield so you know who to pass to. And that was the biggest gripe that I had with the original, because you needed windows to see who to pass to. Now you can see where your receivers are in relation to the rest of the field. Otherwise, it's modern Mutant League Football. The difficulty can be changed from rookie all the way to expert. You can choose how easy it is for players to get killed. The same goofy player and team names are there as well. If the only football game you've played in the last 25 years was Mutant League Football, you'll feel right at home with Mutant Football League. The controls are fluid, and since this game runs at a smooth 60 frames on PC, it feels a lot faster. You can sprint and juke in this game since we now have more than 3 buttons to work with. The game also has a tutorial mode to walk newcomers through the game, and it can even be turned off if you'd rather just play. I like that touch since fresh installs are usually met with tedious, unskippable tutorials. The humor that was present in Mutant League Football is present in Mutant Football League, but increased tenfold. You now have a color announcer that reads a play-by-play and makes jokes with his co-host. The names are similar to the original, but a lot more creative. The teams are well thought out and make this game feel really polished. Each field has different obstacles and are much more present, like these pikes that come up on specific yard lines to screw with you as you're running the ball, or these giant worms who come out of the end zone and eat your player. One improvement over the original is that you can see your player's hit points, and this is important because your players can be killed on the field, and there are a ton of ways to get killed. Exploding footballs, electric fences, giant ogres, the list goes on. I didn't have too many gripes about this game, but the announcer's color commentary seems a little bit clunky. There are noticeable gaps in between stating the team's names. It feels like the processing could use some tweaking. If you're playing Madden, the color commentators feel so cohesive, and so that's what makes Mutant Football League seem like a step back. But it's not a deal breaker. I would have also liked a way to make my own custom figure instead of being locked into a preset roster. The AI is fair, and it does take some time to figure out which plays to select so you don't get your butt handed to you. It feels satisfying to win a game because it does get pretty crazy. I was playing one game and I didn't realize that the team had bribed the ref. I had 3 interceptions overturned before I figured it out. Once I killed the referee, the game became a bit more fair. Overall, Mutant Football League is a pretty awesome game for the price, and I'm surprised that this was a Kickstarter game. Typically, these have a lot of quirks, and as far as I can tell, there aren't any. Also, this game came out on schedule. They started last year and actually released the game on PlayStation and Xbox One early. There aren't any arcade football games anymore. Gone are NFL Blitz and high-impact football titles to balance the simulation football feel of Madden. $20 is an amazing price, and best of all, there aren't any microtransactions, which is really refreshing. So that wraps it up for this review. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up, and if you're new here, why not subscribe so you'll never miss an episode? Thanks so much for watching, I'm Super Nintendo, and I'll see you next time.